what I like to do is talk about anything and everything classic rock related. So you know what? Let's just go ahead and get into some classic rock news. So for any of us who are Eddie Money fans, we all got some pretty terrible news over the weekend. Eddie Money has been diagnosed with stage 4 cancer. It's in his esophagus, it's in his stomach, and it's in his liver. The promo for his Access TV show Real Money put out this promo, so he's known for quite a while. I believe he found out at the end of last year, and he thought he was going to the doctors for just a regular checkup, and he was told that he had cancer. So I cannot even imagine what it was like for his family to get the news and to put this out to the world. Everyone has been continuously streaming and giving him their best wishes, so hopefully we can all do that. If you had not heard about the news, please go ahead and reach out to Eddie. You can find Eddie on Facebook at Eddie Money and on Instagram and Twitter. I'm Eddie Money. Please send him a message, tell him you love him, because his family is reading all of those messages to him. Honestly, just getting the news about Eddie, he's only 70 years old, and just the fact that he's done so much and he's given so much, he's done a lot for our vets, he's done a lot for animals, he's just given and given and given, and so if we could just give a little bit, just a little message, send it off to Eddie. I'll link his contacts for Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter in the description box. Just that little bit of reaching out and letting him know that his fans love him, it would probably just mean the world. So all of our best and all of our love and all of our good wishes to the Money Man, Eddie Money. Brian Johnson, former lead singer of AC/DC, but is he gonna be the new? How do you say new? He can't be the new singer of AC/DC for crying out loud, but will he be the lead singer once again? I think so. I think everybody thinks so. I think we all know it's going to happen. They've been under wraps recording new music. We'll see. Come on. Of course, Brian Johnson's gonna be back with AC/DC. No brainer.
What brain?
Well, Brian Johnson had an amazing TV show for himself in Britain called Brian Johnson, A Life on the Road, and it did so well, fans love it so, so much, that of course, Access TV is going to carry it. And of course, I don't get Access TV, but an amazing YouTuber, Lindy, thank you so much, let me know that you can get a lot of these Access shows on Vudu. Who knew about Vudu?
What do you do with Vudu?
Now, a lot of shows are free. Some of the shows you do have to pay for, but it's worth it if you want to see Sammy Hagar's Rock and Roll Road Trip, or you want to see Eddie Trunk interview Lou Gramm and Joe Perry and Vince Neil, then it's worth it. You pay a few bucks to see these amazing shows. Why not? Now, Brian's first guest on his show in America on Access TV will be Sting playing Sting. Because you don't even have to say Sting formally of the Police, because Sting has done such a great job becoming Sting and just being known as Sting. He's Sting. He's just Sting. So Sting will be Brian Johnson's first guest on his show, Brian Johnson, A Life on the Road. With Brian Johnson. A Life on the Road with Brian Johnson and Sting, because he's Sting. September 15th. The Rolling Stones, Mayan, their No Filter tour is just kicking butt.
I want the Rolling Stones, I kick my butt.
People are loving these guys. They are just, I haven't heard a bad thing about their show yet. Well, they were recently at the Rose Bowl in California, and you know how it is. You get tickets to a concert, you're so excited. You go and you maybe even buy a new outfit. You make sure you look dang good before you walk out that door and you go to that concert. And then you get to the concert and they won't let you in. Why? Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? Well, a few months ago, we all know that Mick had to have heart valve replacement surgery, so a bunch of their shows were actually canceled. Of course, he was in the hospital. He couldn't perform. When you're on a gurney, it's hard to sing. So fans are being told, don't worry, those tickets are going to be honored wherever and wherever they reschedule, so it's no biggie. I'd be like, yeah, okay, cool, baby. I just have my tickets. I have my tickets. I am all set and ready to go. Well, some fans were not all set and ready to go because when they got to the door and they handed their ticket to the person who takes the tickets or they scanned it, they were told their tickets were fake.
My ticket's not fake.
Oh my, can you even imagine? I cannot. I cannot imagine how that must have felt, especially going to the Rolling Stone show. But I think it was like 40 people this happened to. They called StubHub. I'm guessing it happened to other ticket holders as well, maybe Ticketmaster. I don't know, I'm just saying. I just heard about StubHub customers, and a few of the people were able to contact StubHub and they were able to go to the show after being denied entry. There are a few who did not get in and have to get their money back. I'm sorry for how you feel. Really, I feel so, so bad because you get so psyched up. You're going to see an amazing show, the Rolling Stones, especially if you had never seen them before, and then you get there and they won't let you in. Not nice. So hopefully, StubHub steps up, and they give back like more than what the ticket price was worth, because that stinks, right? I mean, that just totally stinks. At that same Rose Bowl show, the Rolling Stones got bequeathed an amazing honor. Robert Downey Jr., you remember him. He's still a cutie patootie. Well, he went on stage on behalf of NASA, and he presented the Rolling Stones with a rock. You'd think it would be a stone, but it was a rock. A rock that's sitting on Mars. Here's the thing. How do you know that rock is even still there? How do you know that rock was on Mars? I mean, they have footage. The satellite took a video or something like that. It gets windy on Mars. How do you know that rock didn't just get blown off of Mars? I mean, because really, is it just a round thing? I don't know. Did they mark the rock? Did they take the rock? Is the rock in a case? Or is the rock still on Mars with their names on it? I don't know. But we do know the Rolling Stones have their own rock on Mars. Thank you. Thank you, NASA. That is pretty cool, though. I mean, I would rather have a planet. I mean, they could name a planet after the Rolling Stones. But they did get a rock, so that's nice. Bret Michaels, yes, he is just so cute. Well, he loves to give back, and that guy loves to perform. I mean, he is on the road, I think, 363 days out of the 365 days of the year. I really, really do, because he's super busy. Well, he's added more tour dates. It's called the Hometown Heroes Tour. And because he's just so cool, he's going to be donating some proceeds from each show to the JDRF Foundation. And that supports type 1 diabetes. So amazing. We all know Bret is a diabetic. And some of those monies will be going to other local organizations as well, because that's just what Bret does. He helps people out. He's just so cute. I mean, really, he's just adorable. I'm hoping he adds more dates because he's not coming anywhere around here. Of course not. Like Access TV is not anywhere around here. Maybe he will. I don't know. I'm hoping. Fingers are crossed. Does that look bad? Well, they're crossed. He's got 5 dates scheduled, and Bret is taking some of his CannaFest friends with him. Lita Ford, Night Ranger, Firehouse. I don't think all of them are going to perform at each show. He's going to have either one of them or two of them. It'd be kind of cool if all of them went, though, and performed with him at each one of those shows. But it's like a mix. You know, everybody's got things to do. Everybody's busy. So I am hoping that Bret brings his Hometown Heroes tour here to New England, because that would be really nice. That would be really nice, Bret. It really, really would. Please and thank you. And you can catch out all of this info and more on his website at bretmichaels.com. Bret with one T. One T. One T for me. Bretty. bretmichaels.com. Gene Simmons, Mr. Man of Kiss, he's on his End of the Road tour. He literally just celebrated his 70th birthday. And he celebrated it eating a hot dog while leaning against a New York City police officer's car. Oh, and his family took him bowling, which is so fun.
I love to go bowling.
I don't even see how he has time to do anything. That guy is so, so busy. Not only with the tour, but he's got all of these other projects going on. And it was just released that he stepped down as chief evangelist officer of Invicta, that CBD company that sells drinks and all types of CBD stuff. So he's not doing that anymore. He was with them for about 17 months. No word on why he stepped down, but he did. And Gene is just out there kicking it on the end of the road tour with his compadres. Kiss. Happy birthday, Gene. Guys, that's all I got for classic rock news. If you like this type of thing, please hit the subscribe button and the notification bell, because if I come up with something, I'll just pop it on here. I really appreciate it. Guys, have a great day, a great night, a great weekend, a great everything. And as always, remember, most importantly, to keep rocking.